Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about to float or not to float. Not a boat, not a marine craft, but floors. Because I get a lot of calls from people say, well, I want to float the floor. And I said, okay, why do you want to do that? And they really can't tell me other than the fact that they've heard that that's a good idea. Well, in acoustics, if you've heard it's a good idea, you need to do a little bit more research because there's a lot of misinformation out there. There's a lot of half-truths, a lot of hyperbole, a lot of innuendo. So you really want to put science first and opinion and the literature second. Do your own research, okay? Floating floors. What really is a floating floor? Well, it's not really floating. It's just raised above the existing structure, okay? And what is it? Well, we know from past videos that it's a barrier technology. So what do we do with a barrier? If we have a noise source here, and we're here, and we don't want to hear the noise, we build a barrier. Now, the barrier must be in relationship to the amount and level of the noise. We won't put up a curtain to stop the noise from a garbage truck. It won't work. Because the barrier or the curtain is not designed at the right frequency and amplitude of the noise. The frequency and amplitude of the noise must be designed into the barrier, or else you're just wasting time, money, and expensive real estate. So if you're going to float your floor, you want to make sure that the noise you're creating in the room won't get to the structure below, or the noise in the structure below won't get up into your room. So you construct a barrier, okay? And one of the ways to do that is a floating floor. But you must qualify and quantify the frequencies that you're dealing with. And this can only be done through measurements. And we do what's called a 7-day measurement time study. Noise time study. So what are we looking for in that time study? And we have a service that we offer for that, that you can even do yourself with iPhone apps that I've come up with. So what are we really trying to do here? We're really looking at two ends of a spectrum. We're looking at energy below 125 hertz, and we're looking at energy above 125 hertz, because this is the frequency breakpoint for how thick the wall is. Could mean the difference. This could be 4 inches if we're above 125 hertz. If we're below 125 hertz, this wall could go up to 12 inches. So there's a big difference in thickness. There's a big difference in materials that you use. There's a big difference in the way you build it. So first we have to know what our problem is, how big it is, and then we have to build the right barrier to satisfy the requirements of the noise. Not what we think is necessary. So floating floors are very expensive. So make sure that you have the noise that you have to stop with the floating floor. Now, is the floating floor the only thing that you can do? No, there's other things you can do to stop noise. And we'll get into that with another video. So I hope this helps to float or not to float. First, let's find out if we need to by measuring and seeing where our problems are, and then we can go from there. Thank you. Hi everyone, thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support, and if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. Our room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website, and there's a book now button so you can book a appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it, because I need all that information when we talk. But I'll be happy to accommodate you. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.